Hello everyone, Matt here. Today we're going to create a fusion table, a crafting table-like block using the MCreator's new procedure system. First, we need to create the textures for the mod. As this is not the focus of this tutorial, we'll speed it up. I created all the textures using a free program called GIMP. We need to draw an arrow for the block's interface that will represent the direction of crafting. I decided to go with a dark gray color with a slightly lighter upper left border and a darker bottom right one, to make it look a bit raised. Then we need to draw the textures for the block itself. For the bottom part, I simply overlaid some white noise over the light red color I used for the base. For the side texture, it will be a simple striped texture with some sort of burning ball on it. For the top, I went with a crafting table-like design that resembles the block's interface. I decided to add a block solely for crafting with an iron block-like design. Now onto the MCreator part. First, we need to add the red iron block, since that's going to be the base for the machine's recipe. We need to import every block texture we are going to use. I decided to prepare the textures for later by importing them all at once. Now we need to set the textures. In the next step, we simply name the cube and adjust its properties to our likings. Now we create the block's recipe. I went with an iron cube in the middle, some redstone powder on each side of it, and redstone blocks on the top and the bottom side. Now we can create the fusion table block. I just set the texture to the side texture and change the top and bottom ones for the corresponding ones. Now we need to set the block's name. I'll go with fusion table. Then we adjust the parameters to make the block a bit special. In this case, I wanted the machine to drop only two blocks of red iron. Since the block itself is going to be crafted out of metal, we can make it sound more realistic by setting the material to iron and soldering step to metal. We don't need any particles. We need to enable inventory with 3 inventory slots. Doing so, we enable the block to hold items. And that's it for the block. Now we need to make a recipe for the fusion table block. I decided to go with 2 red iron blocks, 2 TNTs, 2 brick blocks, and a pressure plate on the very top. We also need to set the fusion table as the recipe's result. Now to the most important part, the crafting procedure. Before we begin, let me introduce you to 2 logic gates, AND gate and OR gate. They both take 2 inputs and output boolean values which are either true or false. The AND gate outputs true only if both conditions are met, or however, outputs true when at least one condition is met. First, we need an IF statement with 1 AND gate that contains 1 more AND gate and an OR gate. Now we need 3 block comparators and 1 number comparator. The first item block comparator is going to check for the first ingredient. In our case, that's always going to be iron block. Then we need to check for the second ingredient, which in this case is redstone dust. The third item block comparator is going to check whether the output slot has the same item type as the recipe's result. Now we need to compare the blocks and items with the actual slot contents. We can find those blocks under the block actions tab. The number comparator is going to check whether the output slot is empty, since we want to allow crafting when it is. We can now add two blocks that will remove a single item from each input slot. After that, we need to increase the number of items in the output slot by 1. We do that by reading the number of items in the output slot, increasing it by 1 and setting the new value. We now recommend it to check for any potential mistakes, just like we did. Doing so, you can avoid a lot of frustration. If you want, you can now add more recipes simply by selecting the if statement and copying it by pressing Ctrl plus C and pasting it using Ctrl plus V. You simply need to change the ingredients in the first two item block comparators, the output item or block in the third item block comparator, and in the block where we set the number of items in the output slot. We decided to add recipes for diamond and gold blocks just for demonstration purposes. We now need an interface. First, we bind it to the Fusion Table's inventory. Then, we can open the editor. We can now add the arrow that we created earlier in the middle of the GUI. Then, we add the title. I decided to color it bright red. Now we can add the slots. Be careful, the order is very important. First, we add the top slot. That's where the iron blocks will be put. Then we can add the second slot, which I colored yellow. This one will be used for the second item, which would be redstone, diamonds and gold. The third slot is going to be used for outputting items. We colored it bright red. Now we can add the fuse button with the crafting procedure bound to it. That way, it's going to craft one item on each click. We can now click Save Changes and exit the editor. The last thing we need is to add a procedure that will open the interface. Go to Player Management tab and drag Open GUI block. Make sure that you select the right GUI if you have more than one. We now bind the procedure to the when right-clicked event on the Fusion Table block. That's it. All we need to do now is to craft the table and test it. We need red iron, TNT, brick blocks and a pressure plate. As you can see, you can now use the table to craft red iron, diamond and gold blocks. You cannot craft if the items in the output slot don't match the result of the current recipe. You can download this mod and its workspace using the link in the description. Thank you for watching this tutorial. don't forget to subscribe, turn on the notifications, like for more content like this, and comment with suggestions down below. Stay tuned!